All right, you primitive screwheads, listen up. See this? This is my boomstick! The 12-gauge double-barreled Remington. S-Mart's top of the line. You can find this in the sporting goods department. That's right, this sweet baby was made in Grand Rapids, Michigan. Retails for about $109.95. It's got a walnut stock, cobalt blue steel, and a hair trigger. That's right. Shop smart. Shop S-Mart. You got that? Well, hello, Mr. Fancy Pants. I got news for you, pal. You ain't leading but two things right now. Jack and shit. Jack left town.
Now that's what I call cleavage.
Lady, I'm afraid I'm going to have to ask you to leave the store.
Who the hell are you?
Name's Ash. Housewares.
What, you never saw a guy with a chainsaw hand before?
Shoot first, think never.
Noted.
Yo, she bitch.
Let's go.
Dinner before Daddy excused you.
There go the dishes! There go the truth!
You found me beautiful once.
Honey, you got real lucky.
I'd do me. All day long.
But what of the things that we've shared? What of all the sweet words that you spoke in private?
Oh, well, that's just what we call pillow talk, baby. That's all.
But reading from the book is what caused all this trouble to begin with, so...
Yeah, that's true. But reading from it again can't make things any worse. It's kind of like spilling paint on a painting. It's okay because there's already paint on it.
That is incorrect.
But in my own way, I am king.
Hail to the king, baby.
Oh, what's up, dude? Do you like Ice Nine Kills? Oh, yeah, love Ice Nine Kills. Let's see how it should have gone.
Do you like Ice Nine Kills?
Not really.
Their early work was a little bit too seen for me, but when the Silver Scream came out, I think they really came into their own, commercially and artistically. The whole album has a refined melodic sensibility that really makes it a cut above the rest. Hey, Paul!
Searching for redemption.
Someone call the doctor. Got a case of it on my
palm. I'll be good. I will.
All I need is my body. My pussy pink just like salami. Don't need no drink to get naughty. Cause bitch, I'm not Bill Cosby. My pussy.
I'ma grow up and be an astronaut. I'm on a Mexican radio.
Villain? The villains all died. This is a movie about a heroine. What are you talking about?
I'm seeing that a few people asked me to do Carrie in the Villains That Had a Point series. And let me tell you why I'm not. Because she doesn't belong in that series. Because Carrie was not a villain. As someone who was the bully's bully in high school, I saw right through this movie. Even when I watched it in middle school, I was like, yeah, they got what they deserve. But she quite literally was minding her business the entire time. Her mom was abusing her. Then she gets to the school. These girls teasing her for something that naturally happens to everybody. And there is only one person that takes up for her. Even the teachers was acting like they ain't had no sense. They looked this sweet baby angel in the face, convinced a football player to go to prom with her, rigged it so that she would win prom queen, have the time of her life in the meantime, and then they ruined her night. You thought that she was gonna go back to her abusive mother without activating got me fucked up on these people? She did exactly what she needed to do. Burnt that school to the ground. She was resourceful. Every single thing they had in that gym that she could use to ruin them kids' lives, she did. Basketball hoops, smashing people. Tables, collapsing. Water, electrocutions. Candles, burning people alive. Doors, lock them. I stand a bitch that don't ask for no resources because she gonna use what she got to get what she need to do. And the girl that used to help Carrie was much classier than I was as a high school student, because when I saw people getting bullied, wig, bitch, what you say? And that's what I thought. Do not make me fuck up your grades in this system, girl. Don't make me ruin your life. But no, she made sure that Carrie felt good about herself, and she even got in trouble for trying to help Carrie. Then I had to stand even harder when she said, you know what? The one girl that helped me, you can go ahead and get out. The rest of y'all though, done. And what did the bullies do? They gonna try to run. But my girl had a mission, and she followed them down the street and made that car flip over. But not until she looked them in the eye so they knew who did it. Baby, I had to stand. Then my girl comes back, takes a shower, says, I have got to get all this off of me. And her mama starts it with her, and she said, you know what? Crumble this bitch to the ground. Baby, where did the rocks come from? Girl, honestly, this is a fantastic movie. Same realm as Cinderella to me. Even though she died, may she rest in peace, because baby, you did what needed to be done.
Okay, hear me out. Purge, but Barbie Purge. Dress in pink, get ready for a fun night out with the gals. Purge style.
Just an amazing father, always getting drunk and beating us. He's dead now.
Where'd you get that piano?
I don't want to hurt anybody. I don't enjoy hurting anybody. I don't like guns or bombs or electric chairs. But sometimes people just won't listen. And so I have to use persuasion. And slides. My parents, Sharon and Dave, generous, doting, or were they? All I ever wanted was a ballerina Barbie in her pretty pink tutu. My birthday. I was 10. And you know what they got me? Malibu Barbie.
Malibu Barbie.
The nightmare.
The nerve.
That's not what I wanted. That's not who I was. I was a ballerina. Graceful, delicate. They had to go.
Storytelling. It's time to face your fear.
Valheim, the mayhem of my Carnage Factory! Are you ready for those gates to open?
Jesus Christ, Boogie. Jesus fucking Christ, you're the Bay Harbor Butcher.
I really hate that name.
Maria, that psychopath set me up.
I'll always be a step ahead of you.
Our primary suspect is someone you know well, Sergeant James Dokes.
Early morning, double feature, Rocky Horror, Picture Show.